Hello, my intelligent tiny tots. We are meeting again. And this time, we are going to discuss a very interesting topic. A topic called How We Communicate. This is your chapter number 9 in your textbook. Communicate. We do this every day. Let's see how we communicate, and there are some types of communication. So we are going to study that in this chapter. Let's start. Let's see the big idea of this chapter. What is the big idea? There are different ways of sharing information and ideas. Whatever information we have or idea that strike our mind, there are various ways how we can share our ideas to others. And this is what we are going to see this in chapter. Things to learn. In this chapter, we will learn means of one-to-one communication. What do you mean by one-to-one communication? And what are the things we use to communicate one-to-one? And means of one-to-many communication. One person communicating to a big lot of people. Let's see. Children, let's see the let's go section in this. Observe the following pictures and write what kind of communication each of them is showing. It is very easy for you. You will have to write down whether it is one-to-one or one to many. Now, by the pictures, I'll explain you what it means. See, this is the first picture. It is a picture of a post box. Somebody is posting a letter in it. Now, when you write a letter to somebody, what type of communication it will be? It is you communicating to somebody, some one person. So it becomes one-to-one communication. We will learn in detail in further slides. Now, this is the most favorite one. It is a television. You spend most of the time with the television, right? Television gives us information, and it gives information to so many people together. So it becomes one-to-many communication. The next picture is newspaper. Again, newspaper goes to so many places. So many people read the news of same type. So it becomes one-to-many communication. I will make it more clear in this lesson further. Communication, such a big word. Let's understand what do we mean by communication? Yes, in simple words we can say talking or sharing our ideas is communication. Let's see the definition. When a person talks to another person or a group of people, it is called communication. Now, when you talk to your friend, you're talking to only one friend. That is communication. Or when you are talking to the whole class, a group of people, again, that is also called communication. In simple, communication means talking, sharing our ideas, sharing our feelings with others. Now, let's understand. Once we understood, communication means talking, sharing. Then what is means of communication? A person can share information, thoughts and ideas and feelings with another person by communicating. We saw that you can give your ideas, your thoughts, your feeling, whatever you feel by communicating, talking to another person. But there are different ways in which we can communicate. It's not only by talking we can give our ideas or feelings to others. There are many ways, and we will learn that ways. Now, these ways are called means of communication. They are the media through which we share our ideas to others. Children, let's see one-to-one communication first and we'll study about their means. One-to-one, when one person talking to one person, right? When we communicate with only one person at a time, that is called one-to-one communication. When a teacher is talking to the whole class, she is talking to so many. But when she is talking to you only, one person, that becomes one-to-one communication. One person talking to only one person. Now we will see what are the various means of one-to-one communication. It's not only talking to person we can share our ideas. There are many ways. Now imagine if your friend is living very far from you, right? The friend is not in Surat, he's somewhere else. How will you communicate with that friend if you want to share the ideas? Yes, what are these? Letters. By writing letters also we can communicate. Okay. So letters, when we send letters to people from a post office, we studied about the post office and post works in the last chapter. So when we send letters to somebody, we are communicating, we are sharing our ideas. The postman delivers letters to us. If someone else writes letters to us, the postman comes and gives that letter to us. Again, that is a communication. And letters take a few days to reach us. Now, only thing, the problem with letters is when you want to share your ideas to somebody, you have to wait. It takes few days to reach to that person. So when letters take so much time, what can be the fastest process? Email. When you write an email to your friend, to your teacher, to any institute, again that is a means of communication, right? So email, and email stands for electronic mail. Through electronic device, we send a mail, and so the full form of it is electronic mail. We send messages to people much faster through emails. Emails are very fast. We just write an email and we send it, and the moment we click the send button, it reaches to the opposite person. An email can be sent either from a computer or from your mobile phone also. It is accessed to the mobile phone also. Now one more, the most fastest one. Telephone. A telephone is one of the fastest means of communication. And when we talk in telephone, children, we directly get a response from our friends also. You want to talk to your friend, if you mail, you will have to wait for his reply. But when you call that friend, you will get the reply on spot. So it is called the fastest means of communication. Nowadays, we use mobile phones also, right? These type of telephones were used in the olden days. Now also you have it at your place, but mobile phones also are the best, fastest means of communication. They have made communication fast and very easy.